Hello, and welcome to Lenze Training. This tutorial will show you how to integrate the Lenze i950 as a positioning device into an Ethernet IP control system. After connecting an Ethernet cable into the engineering port of the i950 drive, open up EC Starter and go online with the device. Make sure you have the correct IP address for the i950 you're connecting to by pinging it. Then click Insert to connect to it. Here, we want to go into the Settings tab and change the application type to Technology Application Table Positioning. Before moving on to anything else, you should set up your motor. For a Lenze motor, you can input the C86 code found on your motor tag, and it will import all the motor characteristics correctly. Then go to the TA table positioning section, and in this page, you can see the basic settings that are related to positioning and some top-level signal flow of the modes that show you how they affect one another. Change these parameters to your specific values. There are two main ways to use the table positioning application. You can either use a predefined profile value table that can be selected from the PLC, or you can send external set points from the PLC. For the profile table method, you can go to the profiles subsection under TA table positioning and change these values to fit your needs. Afterwards, you can select the correct bits in the control word to activate the profile you want to run. These are in binary, so what that means is that if you were to have profile 1 and profile 2 selected, then profile 3 will be the one that runs. For the external setpoint method, you can simply activate the bit called Activate External Position in the control word to allow for the drive to reference the setpoint from the external position parameter. You can do the same for external velocity and other parameters like acceleration and deceleration as well. You can see the control and status words from the PLC in the interface subsection easily. Here, you can also control the i950 through EC Starter instead of the field bus by clicking on Activate Internal Control. This unlinks the blue lines of communication here. And since I will be controlling this through the PLC today, I will leave this unchecked. You can go to the signal flow subsection to see how all the modes are tied in together. And you can also click on any blue text, which will bring you to the page to set up that mode. Remember that all of these parameters can be searched for in the parameter list tab. And you can add the ones that you use most often or need to get to quickly to your favorites folder as well. Lastly, you want to go into the Ethernet IP section to set up your IP configuration so that it can communicate with your PLC. You can do this using DHCP or manually storing a fixed IP address in the drive. Now let's move on to the PLC side. You should have an Ethernet IP EDS file downloaded from the Lenze official site. This can be found in the Engineering Data tab of the Downloads section. And afterwards, install the EDS files using the EDS hardware installation tool. The Rockwell software should now be able to recognize the i950 as a device. Right-click on the Ethernet section of the program tree and click Add New Module. Search for Lenze devices and then click on the i95A as an AC drive device. Give it a name and some description about what you're using the device for. Then assign an IP address to it. This should be the same IP address if you gave the i950 a fixed IP address in EC Starter. Then click the Change button to select the type of input and output structure. In this case, I can come here and select the Lenze TA table positioning mode, since that's what I selected in EC Starter. The process for setting up other technology applications is the same here. Just select the one you want, and the size and type of the input and output configuration will change automatically. Then go to the connection tab and make sure you have the cycle time you want, and that the input type is unicast. After that, click OK, and you should be ready to go. So I can go online, download the program, and once the program is running, I can go to the controller tags, and as an example, activate the external position bit, and then change the position value. So now if you go back to EC Starter, you can see that the values have been communicated to the i950. Setting up the i950 for table positioning is as easy as that. See you in our next video.